Hi friends, this is Sarojini here. Welcome to my networking channel. Hope all are doing good. And today let us debug the OSPF issues. So I have configured the OSPF version 3, that is the OSPF for IPv6. So I configured OSPF on R1 and R2, and this is the directly connected interface IPv6 address. So due to some issues, R1 I am not able to establish the OSPF neighbor relationship with R2. So let us go and check the directly connected interface. I can check show IPv6 interface faster than 0/0. So you can see IPv6 enabled, right? It will create the link local address for neighbor communication, and also I configure the global unicast address. This is a routable address, this is the IPv6 address of this corresponding interface. And also now let us check on R2. So R2, let us check IPv6 interface fast Ethernet 0/0. So both this interface are up, and both are getting the link local and the global unicast. This is a global unicast address, which is a routable address. So both are getting the address and both the interface are up. So now let us check the corresponding interface. Show run interface fast Ethernet 0/0. And also let us check in R2. That is show run interface fast Ethernet 0/0, right? So let us check. So here I configure the authentication as null, and here there is an IPsec authentication. So that is the reason it is not able to establish the neighbor relationship. What is the command you can check is show IPv6 OSPF neighbor. So it is not able to establish the neighbor relationship because of the authentication mismatch, right? If you want, we can do the debug also. So we'll go to R2 and let us do a debug. So already it is enabled, right? You are seeing the IPsec packet, not IPv6. So what the packet it received from the neighboring router, it is not an IPsec packet, right? So here we have configured as a null authentication, and this we have configured as a IPsec authentication. So what the packet it received from the neighboring router, it is saying it is not a IPsec packet. So that is the main reason it is not establishing the neighbor relationship with R2, right? So how to fix it? Now let us remove this authentication. So go to configuration mode and let us interface fast Ethernet 0/0. So no IPv6 OSPF authentication. So let us give the entire thing. So did I remove the authentication? So now let us check show run interface fast Ethernet 0/0. So the authentication is removed. So now let us check whether we are able to establish a neighbor relationship. So still we are not able to establish the neighbor relationship with R2. So what might be the reason? Now let us go to the second issue, right? So let us go to the second issue, and now let us check it out. Show IPv6 OSPF interface fast Ethernet 0/0. So we're able to see here both are in area 0, and let us see this also. Show IPv6 interface fast Ethernet 0/0. So two to three things you have to always check. First, you have to always check the network type. Network type is broadcast here. And here also network type is non-broadcast. So the network type is not matching. That is the first reason. Second thing, also you have to check the area. So both are in area 0 or not. So both are configured in the same area 0. And now the authentication is matching. This is also null authentication. And this is also we are seeing the null authentication, right? There is no issue with the authentication parameter. And let us check the hello parameter. Hello is 30 and 120. So here you are seeing hello is 10 and 40. So for a broadcast network, the hello timer is 10 and 40. And this I have configured as a non-broadcast. That is one of the reasons it is not forming the neighbor relationship. So now let us go and rectify. Let us go to the router R2. We need to rectify this. It is showing as a non-broadcast, right? It's showing as a non-broadcast network. So let us rectify that. Go to the configuration mode, interface, fast Ethernet 0/0. No IP, so IPv6, right? IPv6 OSPF network. Let us configure as a non-broadcast network, or you can remove this network. So now let us check the interface. So now you are able to see, right? You are seeing the process up, and the neighbor is coming from loading to full. So it is neighbor is coming up, and let us go to R1 first. Show IPv6 OSPF neighbor. So now the neighbor relationship established. I have created the loopback address for R2 2.2.2. This is a, we will assign this as a router ID, and similarly let us go to R2. Show IPv6 OSPF neighbor. So now both the neighbor interface are up. If you want, you can check the routing table. Show IPv6 route OSPF. So I'm able to see the OSPF remote interface destination network. Similarly, let us go to R2 and check. Show IPv6 OSPF नहीं पर यू ऑलरेडी चेक ड्रेन, सो शो आईपी OSPF OSPF राउट OSPF, दैट इज अ कमांड. सो यू आर एबल टू सी द OSPF राउट नेटवर्क राइट, 2001:1/128, दिस इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिस्टेंस, 110 इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिस्टेंस. सो दिस इज हाउ यू हैव टू कॉन्फिगर एंड वी हैव टू डीबग द OSPF रिलेटेड इशू. सो आई होप यू एंजॉय दिस वीडियो. Before that, let us. I want to show one more thing. Let us check the packet tracer also. So IPv6. Let us check the packet tracer. So we're able to see the packet, right? Hello packet is establishing between the neighbor, establishing for neighbor relationship, and after that you will check all the DBD packets, right? Database reception packet. So always the it will check the hello packet for establishing neighbor relationship. DBD is a database description. That means it will share the link state updates between the neighboring router. That is a DBD. Database synchronization is a DBD packet. Then it will send a LSR request. That is a link state request. So if it is requesting any update, it will send a LSR to neighboring router, and neighboring router will send a LS update. Then it will send a LS acknowledgement accordingly. So this is how the neighbor relationship established for OSPF version 3. It is more or less function like OSPF version 2. So OSPF version 2 using for IPv4. This version 3 is for IPv6 environment, right? So I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe me for more videos. Thank you and have a wonderful day.